In Exodus chapter 29, verses 31 through 46, and again we see this food and drink imagery presented. Before, we saw the table of presence, which signified that God actually wants to dwell with his people, to eat and to drink with his people. Here in this passage, we see the sacrificial lamb being given to the priests as food in order to consecrate them and sustain them. As a picture of what God does for his people, we see bread and we see wine given as people enter into the tent of meeting, and they come into the tent of meeting. God says, this is where I will speak to you. This is where I will tell you what I have to tell you. And it begins with this communion that the people of Israel have with Yahweh, with God. This imagery, this food and drink imagery, it permeates the Jewish religion, permeates the religious practices that God gives to the nation of Israel. It is one of the most important images that we see throughout the scriptures, one of the most important pictures that we see throughout the Old Testament and in the New Testament. Even in John chapter 6, where Jesus alludes to this law here, this religious practice in the Old Testament, when he says, you must, if you are going to come into my kingdom, you must eat my flesh and drink my blood. They're referring to the food and drink that is presented on the altar that not only consecrates the people, right, but also sustains them. So just as food and drink sustain us physically, just as the sacrificial lamb was to sustain the priest, Jesus, God himself, sustains his people. Not only does he bring us to the point of consecration, of being saved, that moment of conversion when we say, okay, I believe in God and I'm going to give my life to him, but he continues to sustain us. He is the one who holds us together. He is the one who causes us to breathe. He is the one who raptures his people to heaven. He is the one who sends the dead to Sheol. He is the one who sustains all. And this is the picture we are meant to receive when we read about food and drink, the lamb and the bread and the wine throughout the Old Testament, and as this imagery is fulfilled in the New Testament with the person of Jesus Christ.